एस्टिमेशन ऑफ मार्केटेबल सरप्लस एंड मार्केटेड सरप्लस. ओके, दिस इज द टाइटल फॉर अवर टुडेज प्रैक्टिकल एक्सरसाइज, एस्टिमेशन ऑफ मार्केटेबल सरप्लस एंड मार्केटेड सरप्लस. हियर फर्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट वी हैव टू सी दैट इन केस ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज दैट इज द प्रोड्यूसर्स सरप्लस. Producer's surplus. So the definition of the producer's surplus is that the quantity of the produce which is actually made by the farmer or can be available by the farmer to the non-farm population. In case of this, just a second. Sir, I think someone is using their audio. Okay, mute all.
Land ki pallavi. Mute your audio. Okay, start it.
Okay. The first concept we have to see, that is the producer surplus, is that quantity of produce which the farmers actually are made available or can be available to the non-farm population. Farmer is taking various types of the crop production on his farm, and it will be provided from farmer to the non-farm population. Non-farm population means those are the persons which are not engaged in agricultural activity, but various types of the agricultural commodity which will be needed for their consumption. So this is the non-farm population. So any type of the commodity which will be available, can be available or made available by the farmer to the non-farm population, that is called as the producer's surplus. So there are the two types of the producer's surplus. The first one, that is the marketable surplus. And second one is the marketed surplus. These are the two types of the producer surplus, marketable surplus and the marketed surplus. Now in the today's practical session, we have to estimate the various values for the marketable surplus and marketed surplus. So here there are the two types, marketable surplus and marketed surplus. Firstly, we will see the about the marketable surplus. So those are the quantity of the produce which are left as a residual for the farmer for his requirement. This quantity is called as the marketable surplus. Suppose, for example, if farmer has a 10 quintal of the wheat. Farmer has a 10 quintal of the wheat at his disposal that will be produced from the crop production activity. So, if farmer having a requirement, there is a total production is 10 quintal of the wheat, and suppose the 3 quintal is the actual requirement for the farmer for consumption purpose, so it will be the 7 quintal. So this will be the 7 quintal is the marketable surplus. So in marketable surplus, the farmer is going to consider his requirement for various purposes, and the remaining value after considering the various requirement, the remaining value is the marketable surplus. Now the second type of the producer surplus is the marketed surplus. So in marketed surplus, without considering any type of the requirement, the farmer is going to sell all the quantity into the market, that is called as the marketed surplus. So you can see that suppose the farmer has a 10 quintal of wheat at his disposal. So without considering any type of the requirement, if farmer sells that total quantity, that is the whole quantity, 10 quintal of the wheat, so this quantity is called as the marketed surplus. So basic difference in between the two types of the producer surplus is that in case of the marketable surplus, the farmer is going to consider his requirement for various purposes. And in case of the marketed surplus, without considering any type of the requirement, farmer sells the total commodity into the market. So these are the two concepts, two types of the producer's surplus. Now we have to see the relationship between the marketable surplus and marketed surplus. Marketed surplus and marketable surplus. Now all the three types of the relationship existed in between the marketed surplus and marketable surplus. Greater than, less than, equal to. All these three types of the relationship existed in between the marketed surplus and marketable surplus. So we have to justify that all types of the relationship. The first one, if the marketed surplus is greater than that of the marketable surplus, so this holds true in the condition, that is in case of the small farmer. The first relationship in between the marketed surplus and marketable surplus, that is the greater than. So this condition holds true in case of the small farmer. Now, you can see that the small farmers, they having a very less land holding, as well as due to the less land holding, they having a less production on his farm. In case of the small farmer, marketed surplus is greater than that of the marketable surplus due to these things. They having a less land holding, they having a less production. Due to that, the small farmer is going to sell all his commodity into the market without considering any type of the requirement. So this condition holds true in case of the small farmer, because small farmers having a immense or the intense need of the cash. So for that purpose, the small farmers sell all the commodity into the market directly. So the first relationship in case of the marketed surplus is greater than that of the marketable surplus is holds true in case of the small farmer. Now moving on to the second one, marketed surplus is less than that of the marketable surplus. So this condition holds true in case of the large farmer. In case of the large farmer, they having a larger land holding, definitely they are going to cultivate the various types of the crops on his farm. So as a result of that, they having the retention capacity. Large farmer having a larger production on his farm, having the greater retention capacity, and they can store that type of the commodity for a longer period of time, because larger farmer do not need any type of the immense need of the cash. They having the various types of the crops on their farm, so they can sell that type of the one of the commodity, and another commodity they can retain for taking the higher value in the later period. After storing the commodity, when the prices are the good, at that time they can sell their commodity. So this second relationship, that is the marketed surplus, is less than that of the marketable surplus. This holds true in case of the large farmer, because large farmer having a greater retention capacity, they do not need the immense need of the cash. Also, in case of the large farmer, they can substitute one crop for the another crop because they having a larger land holding. According to the prices prevailing, they can change their cropping pattern. They can substitute the one crop for the another crop. So this second condition holds true in case of the large farmer. Now moving on, third one, marketed surplus is equal to marketable surplus. In case of that, this condition holds true in case of the perishable commodity. Perishable commodity. As you know that the perishable commodity get wasted very in a small time. So in that case, the marketed surplus is equal to the marketable surplus. They are not going to consider the larger type of the requirement directly. Whatever the quantity obtained, they are going to sell into the market. So the third condition, that is the marketed surplus is equal to, that means the quantity of the marketed and marketable surplus are the same. Marketed surplus is equal to the marketable surplus. This condition holds true in case of the perishable commodity. Due to of the perishable nature of the products, agricultural products, they have to, that farmer has to sell that type of the commodity immediately into the market. So this third condition is holds true in case of the perishable commodity. So all the three types of the relationship existed in between the marketed surplus and marketable surplus. And this three relationship that can be holds true with the help of these aspects. The first condition, marketed surplus is a greater than that of the marketable surplus. This holds true in a small farmers. Marketed surplus is small or less than marketable surplus. This holds true in case of the large farmer. And marketed surplus is equal to marketable surplus in case of the perishable commodity. Okay, now we have seen the theoretical portion of this practical. What is the producer surplus? What is the types of the producer surplus? So there are the two types, marketable surplus and marketed surplus. Also, we have seen the definition for the marketable surplus and marketed surplus. Now, we have also seen the relationship existed in between marketed surplus and marketable surplus. This is the theoretical portion for this practical exercise. Now, moving on the problem, we have to estimate the marketable surplus and marketable surplus for agricultural commodity. So for this exercise is very important for your semester and practical examination, as nearly 15 to 20 marks problem will be asked in your semester and practical examination. You have to calculate, you have to estimate the marketable surplus and marketed surplus with their percentage. Okay, now we'll see the example. Okay, everyone, in your practical manual, as already we have seen two exercises, you have already written that exercise in your practical manual. So in your practical manual, write down on the right hand side, exercise number 3, write down the title of the exercise. And now I am going to give you a data for calculation or the estimation of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus. So on the left hand side of your practical manual, that is on a blank page, write down problem number 1. Now you have to actually write the data. Problem number 1 on left hand side, that is on a blank page. Problem number 1, write down the problem. Now I am giving the data. You have to write the data. By writing the data, you are able to understand how we are going to estimate the marketable surplus and marketed surplus. Okay, write down the data on the blank page. The first problem, there are 6 adult units in the family of a farmer. There are 6 adult units in the family of a farmer. Everyone write that data in your practical manual on left hand side, that is on a blank page. Because when I going to explain the estimation, so you must having the data. By seeing that data, you can get how I calculate that values. So everyone write that problem. There are the 6 adult units in the family of a farmer. He also maintains 2 milk animals. Full stop. Farmer has sold 120 quintals of wheat. 120 quintals of wheat. Fifteen quintals of soybean. 48 quintals of gram. 60 quintal of jowar. 60 quintals of jowar. And the last value, that is the 30 quintals of paddy. These are the values that will be given as a data for the calculation or the estimation of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus. 120 quintal of the wheat, the farmer has already sold that type of the quantity into the market. 120 quintals of the wheat, 15 quintals of the soybean, 48 quintals of the gram, 60 quintal of jowar and 30 quintal of the paddy in a primary wholesale market. Now we have another data for the estimation of this marketable and marketed surplus. Already you have written this 4 to 5 lines regarding the number of the, this will include the number of the family members in the family of the farmer. They having the 2 milk animals and various types of the commodity the farmer has sold into the primary wholesale market. Now the another data will be given there. Prepare a table. Write down the name of the crop. Wheat. Soybean, tur, gram, jowar, and at the end paddy. This is also data that will be provided for the estimation of the marketed and marketable surplus. So prepare a table having the title, the crop, and write down the name of the various crops: wheat, soybean, tur, gram, jowar and paddy. Now the second, that is the area. What is the area given there for wheat crop? 8, then 2, then 5, again 5, 15 and 5. This is the area for the cultivation of this crop that will be allotted by the farmer for the cultivation. 8, 2, 5, 5, 15 and 5. Now the yield obtained. Yield obtained for the wheat crop: 30, 20, 12, 15, 20 and at the end 40. 30, 20, 12, 15, 20 and 40. This is the yield obtained for this crop from this area. Now this one is very important. Seed requirement. Now in case of the marketable surplus, farmer is going to consider the various types of the requirement. So the values will be given there as the seed requirement. Write down the values of the seed requirement for the wheat crop. 8, 1.5, 1, 3, 1.5, and for the last paddy crop, 2. 8, 1.5, 1, 3, 1.5, and 2. This is the value given for the seed requirement. Now, consumption requirement per adult. Write down the consumption requirement per adult. This is another type of the requirement. Earlier, the requirement is of the seed that will be by the farmer. Now, the consumption requirement per adult by the farmer. Write down the values for the wheat crop 12. There is a no requirement, consumption requirement for the soybean crop. So it will be a zero or the dash. Then for tur, 1.8. Again, 1.8, 6 and 9.5. Consumption requirement for adult, the values given there, 12. For the wheat crop, there is no requirement for the soybean. Then 1.8, 1.8, 6 and 9.5. Write down all the values as a consumption requirement per adult. And the last column of the other requirement. Other requirement. The other requirement will also be given there for the wheat crop. That is the 10. There is a no requirement, other requirement for the soybean crop. Then for the remaining crops, write down the values 0.5, 0.5, 10, 10. This is the values for the other requirement given for the wheat crop 10. There is no requirement for the soybean crop. Then 0.5, 0.5. 10 and again 10. So this is the data that will be provided in your semester in practical examination. Earlier you have written 4 to 5 lines regarding the giving the information regarding the farmer's family members and what type of the quantity the farmer actually sold into the market. And another information will be also provided as a name of the crop, the area, yield, seed requirement, consumption requirement, and the other requirement. So this all total information or the data will be provided to you for the estimation of the marketable and marketed surplus with their percentage. So here is the information we have already given there. I think all you have written that type of the information in your practical manual. Now, we are going to estimate using of this data, that is the marketable surplus and marketable surplus with their percentage. Now we will see, the data is already given there. Now we will see how the values of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus with their percentage we can calculate. Okay, now I am going to take a new table as a explaining how we can calculate these values. Now we have a specific data provided for the estimation of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus. By using of this data, we are going to calculate. So I am going to explain you how to calculate the various values of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus for a single crop. After considering that type of the requirement, you can also able to calculate the remaining values for all the crops. Okay, for estimation of this one, you have to prepare a table having a various headings. The first is a crop. We have already written the various names for the crops. We are right again. Now, this is the actual procedure for the estimation of the marketable and marketed surplus. You have a data. By using of data, we have to calculate this one. Now, I am going to write the various names of the crops that have cultivated by the farmer. Now, I have written the names of the various crops: wheat, soybean, tur, gram, jowar, and paddy. As like that, while solving this type of the problem in semester and practical examination, you also have to prepare a table. And in that table, you have to put all the values that you have calculated as a marketable surplus and marketed surplus. Also, you have to show the calculation for the estimating of the various values for a single crop. Here, I am going to explain you for the wheat crop, how the various values of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus calculated with their percentage. Now, the second column is of the total production. Total production. Now, these things or these headings or this table will not be provided. You have to prepare this table, and by calculating the various values, you have to put into this table. The total production, first value you have to calculate of the total production. Now, the formula for the total production. Total production.
Sir, video off
into yield. While calculating the values for the various crops is of the column of the total production, you have to use this formula. Total production is equal to area into yield. Now, we will solve all the values for only a wheat crop. As like that, by using the various values, you have to calculate these types of the all the values for the various crops, and you have to write in this table. Now, for the wheat crop, the value of the total production by using this formula, total production is equal to area into yield. Now, already you have written that data. The area for the wheat, that is the 8, and the yield is 30. So 8 into 30, it will be 240. So write down the value 240. Here is the formula for the total production. Now, the first value for wheat crop we have calculated as total production. The formula area into yield. The area already you have written in your practical manual. The data will be already you have written. 8. Yield is 30. So 8 into 30, it will be 240 quintals. The value will be written as in the column of the total production, 240. Now, that is the total requirement. In case of the total requirement, we are going to consider the three columns that will be given there. Now, considering the requirement of the three columns, we have a seed requirement will be given in our data. we have a consumption requirement and we have a other requirement. So all these three requirements, taking the summation of all these three requirements, the value will be written in case of the total requirement. Now for the seed, for the seed requirement for the wheat crop, the value will be given as a 8. This will be value of the seed requirement plus the value for given as a consumption requirement 12. And plus the value will be given as a other requirement, that is the 10. These three type of the values will be given in your data. Seed requirement for the wheat crop 8, consumption requirement 12, and other requirement 10. But taking the summation of all these values, you can make the value for the total requirement. But one thing should be noted, that this consumption requirement will be given per adult. As the first line you have written in your problem, there are 6 adult units in the family of a farmer. So this consumption requirement is for only a 1 adult. But in the family of a farmer, there are the 6 persons are there. So it will be a 12 into 6, it will be 72 now. We have to take the 12 per adult into a 6 persons in the family of farmer. So it will be a 72 now. One thing should be reminded, that every time while calculating the total requirement for the various crops, the consumption requirement will be given per adult. Every time consider the number of the family members that will be given in your problem. So in this problem, there are the 6 adult units. So the consumption is, the value will be 12. So 12 into 6, it will be 72. Now taking the addition of this one, 8 plus 72 plus 10, it will be 90. Number of the family members that will be given in your practical, in your problem is very important. By considering this, you can make the value of the total requirement. 8 for the seed production, 72. Why? Because there are the 6 adult units in the family. So 12 into 6, it will be now 72 plus 10 for the other requirement. So 8 plus 72 plus 10, now it will be a 90 as a total requirement. Now the marketable surplus. Marketable surplus. In case of the marketable surplus, we have a formula. Marketable surplus is equal to P minus C. Marketable surplus is equal to P. P is the total production minus C. C is the total requirement. Here we have a total production, that is the 240 for a wheat crop, minus total requirement. Total requirement, we already calculated the value, that is the 90. So it will be 150. The value for the marketable surplus, by subtracting the value of the total requirement from the total production, now it will be 150. This is the formula. Marketable surplus is equal to P minus C. Total production minus total requirement, or the total consumption. So 240 is the total production minus, that is the total requirement. Total requirement, we have the value, the 90. So 240 minus 90, it will be 150. Now the next value we have to calculate as a marketed surplus. Marketed surplus. As by seeing the definition of the marketed surplus, the farmer is going to not consider any type of the requirement and directly sell all the quantity into the market. So earlier we have written the 4 to 5 lines regarding this marketed surplus. Into that lines we have written as the farmer has actually sold. This value is the value of the marketed surplus. 120 quintals of the wheat. This value is already given. The value of the marketed surplus is directly given in your problem. 120 quintals of the wheat, 15 quintals of the soybean, then 48 quintal of the gram. This value will directly you can write in this column. That value already given there, because marketed surplus is that quantity of the produce which farmers actually sells into the market without considering any type of the requirement. So this will be the values for the marketed surplus for the wheat crop. Now, the percentage of marketable surplus and marketed surplus, just not you have to calculate the value of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus, as well as you have to calculate the values of percentage of marketable surplus and marketed surplus. Now, for the wheat crop, we have calculated the value of the total production area into yield, total requirement, considering the requirement, seed requirement, consumption requirement per adult. There are the 6 adults in the family, and other requirement. The value will be 90. Marketable surplus, P minus C, that is the total production minus total requirement. We will take value of the marketable surplus, that is 150. Marketed surplus, the value of the marketed surplus is already given. We do not have make any type of the calculation to get the value of the marketed surplus. Directly the value will be given there, that is the 120. Now we have to calculate the percentage of the marketable surplus. So the formula to calculate the percentage of the marketable surplus and marketable surplus here. Percentage of the marketable surplus, percentage of marketable surplus is equal to marketable surplus divided by the total production into 100. This is the formula to calculate the percentage of the marketable surplus. So percentage of marketable surplus is equal to marketable surplus divided by total production into 100. We have the value of the marketable surplus, that is the 150. 150 divided by total production for the wheat crop, 240 into 100. Now, after solving this one, what will be the value? This value is the percentage of the marketable surplus. So by solving this, the value will be 62.5. You can have to make calculation after this lecture. You have to make the calculation for all the crops, right? You have to write all the values into this table. Just I am explaining the estimation of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus only for the wheat crop. As like that, you have to calculate all the values and you have to put into the table. So percentage of the marketable surplus, the formula: marketable surplus divided by the total production into the 100. So for the wheat crop, we have a marketable surplus 150 divided by 240 is the total production into 100. The value, that is the 62.5%, is the value of the percentage of the marketable surplus. Now the percentage of the marketed surplus, as like that, you have to take the value percentage of the marketed surplus. Percentage of the marketed surplus is equal to marketed surplus divided by the total production into 100. Now we are changing some value. Here the value of the marketed surplus for wheat crop is the 120 divided by the total production. Total production for wheat crop, 240 into 100. So value comes for the percentage of the marketed surplus, that is the 50%. By solving this one, percentage of the marketed surplus, that is the marketed surplus divided by the total production into 100. So these are the some formulas. By using of that formula, you can get the answer for the estimation of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus. The practical implication of application of this exercise is that you can also calculate the marketable surplus and marketed surplus for your farm. you can having the various values, and using of those values you can also calculate the marketable surplus, marketed surplus, percentage of marketable and marketed surplus for your farm also. By using of this, you can say that how much quantity you have uses as a marketable surplus, as a marketed surplus. So as like that, you have to calculate by considering the various data. You have to calculate the marketable surplus, marketed surplus with their percentage. I have going to explain here as the various calculation for the wheat crop. As like that, you have to calculate the various calculation for the various crop, and you have to put that value into this table. Okay, now we are going to conclude this third practical session. In this one, we have seen the practical number 3, estimation of the marketable surplus and marketed surplus for the various agricultural commodities. In that, we have seen the first concept, that is the producer surplus. There are the two types of the producer surplus: marketable surplus and marketed surplus. After that, we have seen the relationship existed in between of these two. So all three type of the relationship existed in the marketable and marketed surplus. Just as there are the certain condition that holds true in the various relationship. After that, we have seen this problem. The data you have already written in your practical manual on left hand side, that is on a blank page. There are the 4 to 5 lines you have written. Into that data, the specific information will be given. After that, you have already write the one table having the various values of the area, yield and various requirement. This all values is already given in your semester end practical examination. And using of this information, you have to calculate the marketable and marketed surplus with their percentage. Already we have discussed in detail for the wheat crop, how we have calculated the value of total production, that is the area into yield. We will get the value of total production 240. Total requirement, considering the total requirement given in the table, in the tabular form information will be given there, for the seed requirement, for the consumption requirement, for the other requirement. One thing always should be noted, that remind that you, while taking the value is given only for a single adult. Always remind that how many numbers of the members are in the family. You have to multiply that type of the consumption requirement with the number of the family. Then marketable surplus, weighing the formula, MS is equal to P minus C, total production minus total requirement, you will get the value of the marketable surplus. Marketed surplus, we have already given the value marketed surplus in the your exam. Then percentage of the marketable and marketed surplus, we have the formula, marketable surplus is equal to percentage of the marketable surplus is equal to marketable surplus divided by the total production into 100. Using of this formula, you can get the value of this percentage of the marketable and marketed surplus. So now we have solved this problem for the crop, wheat crop. As like that, this is the assignment for you. All the 5 remaining crops, you have to calculate the values and put into the table. Okay. Now we will take the attendance.